Graph the function f of theta equals to 2 over 3 cos 2 theta minus 90 degrees plus 1, where theta is between 0 and 360 degrees. Now, with this example, I like to explain you a couple of things. One of the things is the scale which we should be taking on a graph paper. So I've seen students struggling to do graph when fractions are involved, right? Somehow they do manage to get it, but it's important here to choose a proper scale. So our emphasis for this sketch will be, or the graph will be, in selection of correct scale. And second, of course, is understanding the transformation. So when you are given an equation like this, it is important to factor 2 and really see what the phase shift is, right? So we can factor this out and write f of theta equals to 2 over 3 cos of. So we can take 2 common, so we get theta minus 45 degrees plus 1, right? And we are working between 0 to 360 degrees. Okay, so that is for theta and not 2 theta. Okay, 0 to 360 degrees, one cycle only we will draw. Now what you observe here is that the phase shift is 45 degrees. Now that whatever is inside this actually decides on the horizontal axis, and the outside parameters, they decide about the vertical axis, correct? Now since the amplitude is 2 over 3, so it's a good idea to have 1/3 in your vertical axis, right? So we will choose 1/3, 2/3, 3/3. So we'll choose a scale where each division will be 1/3, right? So we know 2/3 is this much, so easy to count. So that is how we have decided about our vertical scale. So this is 1 for us, right? And that is 2 for us. Now that leads us to 1/3, 2/3. So now we can count and really do it in a proper way, correct? That's first thing. So vertical scale is decided. Now about the horizontal scale, we have 45 degrees shift to the right. So if it is a 45 degrees, so each division should be at least 45 degrees. So that is one thing. Now the second thing is time period 2. Now if k is 2, that means what is the time period? So the time period is that the whole wave will actually be horizontally compressed by a factor of 2, I mean half. So the time period will be 360 degrees divided by 2. So the time period for us is 180 degrees. So that means on the horizontal we need 180 degrees, right? To sketch at least one graph. So that is one part of it. Second is, we have a phase shift of 45 degrees. So each division should be at least 45 degrees. So if I make this as 45, this is 90, and that is 180. So that makes my graph very, very small, right? So what I will do is, I will use two divisions as 45, and so the four divisions will be 90. So let this be 90. So that means 1, 2, 3, 4 divisions, 90. 1, 2, 3, 4, and that is 180 for us, correct? So that is how we decided on, you understand, horizontal. So we are taking care of time period. So if I would have used just 45, the whole wave could have come between this, and that graph will not look so nice. So, you know, we spread it out. So that's the whole thing. This also gives us an advantage here. 1, 2, 3, 4, well, that goes out of the scale of 360. So anyway, we will restrict ourselves to this. Otherwise, I would have preferred to show you, 360, and then showed you how it shrinks half, right? Now we understand that our wave is going to be between this to this without phase shift at present. Now, so let me go. So this is 90 degrees for us. Let me write down 90 degrees here, 180 degrees here, and 1, 2, 3, 4, another 90 will give us 270 degrees here, correct? So that becomes our horizontal axis. Since our parameter x in is actually along the axis, where theta, we'll write theta here in degrees, right? And we can write f of theta on a y-axis, correct? So that gives you the starting point of all the things. And now let's try to understand how to sketch our graph, right? So first, I hope scale is correct for you, correct? And you have understood how to select all these things, correct? Now, let's go back to the function. F of theta equals to 2 over 3 cos of 2 times theta minus 45 plus 1. My recommendation is first sketch without horizontal shift and then do horizontal translation. Okay, that is my recommendation, and I think that works best. Because we have been seeing cos curve in a particular way, we know it's kind of like this, right? So it's kind of important to just sketch it first, and then we can always move it left or right. So the first thing we observe is axis of symmetry is at 1. So at 1, let's draw axis of symmetry. So that is our axis of symmetry. So we'll start from here. Always this is the best place to start with. It doesn't matter, just draw a line there, right? Now the second thing which we observe here is amplitude is 2 over 3. So that means we'll go 2 over 3 above the graph and 2 over 3 below the graph. And we know cosine function starts with the maximum, right? So we'll go just 2 over. So this is 1 third and that is 2 thirds. So that is our first point, correct? 2 over 3. And now we know our time period is 180 degrees. So that is, it is going to end at 180 degrees. So that is where it is going to end. So this somewhere here, it will come like this. And right in the center, we will have minimum. So minimum will be how much? Minimum, I'm not considering here. I'm actually at present just drawing, let me write down here. I'm at present drawing 2 over 3 cos of 2 theta plus 1. Let's be very clear about it. With this blue ink, I'm drawing this graph. Later, I will incorporate the phase shift, okay? So my time period is from 0 to 180 degrees for this particular graph. So I have these my maximum points here. And the minimum will be right in the center and will be 2 over 3 below the axis of symmetry. So 1 over 3 and 2 over 3, right? Since we have taken a scale of 1, each division is 1 third. Remember, this is 1 third, 2 third, 3 over 3 is 1, correct? So no harm in understanding how we get 1, right? So 1 over 3, 2 over 3, 3 over 3, which is 1, right? So it becomes an easy counting. Correct. Now, we do know a few points, but to sketch a graph, mainly these are the points, right? And we know for cosine function, when we draw it, now, the 0 is at quarter of the cycle, right? So for the cosine, that is our 0, correct, from the symmetry. So we can always join our graph like this and draw our function, correct? So that is our cos function. We do like this, go like this, kind of. That is our graph for 2 over 3 cos 2 theta plus 1. Now what we will do is we will shift the graph by 45 degrees. That is it. And you know, from here to here it is 90 degrees. So two divisions is 45 degrees. So I'll shift these points. Let me show that in a lighter link here. So we'll shift this point to this place, this point to this place, this point to this place, this point by two divisions on our scale. Is it okay? That is how we are going to shift. And so we get a curve here which will be looking like this, correct? And you see, that is your cosine function now, correct? So that is your final graph, and this graph is f of theta equals to 2 over 3 cos of 2 theta minus 45 degrees plus 1. Correct. So that is your graph. Correct. Do you see that? Now, at times with this graph, we may be asked many things. For example, characteristics of the graph. What is the domain of this function, range of the function, maximum value, minimum value, x-intercepts, y-intercepts. As far as x-intercepts are concerned, there are none. But y-intercepts, well, we have only drawn one wave, but this is periodic, right? So of course, this will definitely go back and hit. So we'll have definitely y-intercepts, right? So the range is from this value to that value, which is 1, 1/3, 2/3. So this maximum value is at 1, 2/3. Do you see that? And the minimum value is 1/3. So the range is from 1/3 to 1, 2/3. Correct? That is kind of critical. And the time period, you know, is 180 degrees. Phase shift is 45 degrees to the right. So that becomes our graph. So I hope you understand with this. Main idea was to how to select the scale of the graph, right? Especially when you have fractions involved, it becomes kind of critical to have a good graph with the scale. Okay, thank you.